Mr. Gore, deficit hawks will tell you that yes, all the problems that Sanjay mentioned, they'll also say that the outgoing government has perhaps left three poison pills for the new government. The food security bill has to be paid, the Food Security Act bill has to be paid, NREGA is a big bill that has to be paid, the pay commission is a bill that has to be paid. So given all of that, do you think growth and sentiment alone can take care of that, or will some hard decisions have to be taken?
No, some hard decisions will certainly have to be taken. I think clearly even things like the land acquisition bill, etc., will need to be revisited. I'm sure because of the strength of this government, they'll be able to do that. I think the thinking in this government also is in terms of trying to change some of these trends that the earlier government has left the country with. So I think they'll do it because they'll be a strong government. And another important thing I think I hope the government now does is reduce the number of ministries. There are far too many ministries.
77 at last count.
The subject is divided between different ministries. And now that he doesn't have to need to accommodate a large number of coalition partners, I hope he does it.
Nilesh, what are the milestones that you would have in mind as you start measuring now or judging, in effect, you know, what this new government will deliver? So decisive mandate, great, hoo-ha, market's very happy. Now's the time to deliver. What are the milestones you're putting in place?
So the first milestone obviously will come in the form of budget. And in a country where there are 50,000 people who are declaring income above 1 crore every year, but there are 200,000 people who are buying motor cars above 10 lakh rupee a year. Clearly there is many things which we can do to improve our tax revenue. If you see our tax to GDP ratio, it is at 10%. In a country like France, it runs at 40%. What deficit we are talking about if we can improve the tax compliance? And being a chartered accountant, I know how our taxation system works. So clearly there is a huge scope of improvement. As Sanjay mentioned, you have government which is asset rich but cash flow poor. You start monetizing your assets. You are sitting on $600 billion worth of PSU investments. You are in business in which you have no business to be in. Monetize that.
You spoke about the Gujarat model, but in Gujarat, one thing that was clear is that Mr. Narendra Modi believes in an efficient public sector, not in divestment. So do you think that will happen?
Again, if you see Gujarat, they don't have Gujarat Hotel Corporation or Gujarat Airline or Gujarat something else. So there is an efficient government sector.
Infrastructure public sector.
But that's probably more of an inheritance. I mean, GSFC was part of Sensex when I was a kid. Now it's no longer a part of Sensex. So yes, GSFC is a great company, but it has not been taken to greater heights like other companies. So budget is the classical thing. The second thing will be revival of investment. I mean, at the end of the day, our 5% below growth rate is attributable to many things, but main thing is that our savings and investments dropped. According to us, there are 13 lakh crore worth of projects which are just lying underutilized. They are just under completion. You try to put up a project saying that I will build it in this much time frame, and if it's going to take this much time frame, the IRR just goes for a toss. So revival of investments by kickstarting these projects, that's something which is really looking forward to. If we can get our investment revival in place, and if we can have a fiscal deficit which is true and reasonably in control, I think battle is half won. Then rest of the things can continue to follow.
Mr. Gore, before we let you go, when will corporate India start investing again? Because we all know that they had stopped investing.
No, I think it will happen very soon. I think sentiment will improve dramatically immediately next week. I think consumption will start increasing. Consumption had fallen on both for durables as well as fast moving consumer goods. I think that will revive and that will lead to investment. I think it will investment will follow very soon. And especially if the government goes out of its way to solve the tax issues on retrospective taxes as well as transfer pricing that have been raised against a lot of foreign corporation, that should be resolved. I think that would lead to tremendous interest in both Indian and foreign companies to dramatically increase investment in
that. And interest rates won't matter so much?
Sorry?
Interest rates won't matter so much?
Yeah, interest rates will matter, but I expect that the inflation will start diminishing now. International commodity prices have been, that will lead to lower interest rates in a matter of a few months.
All right, let me welcome into this conversation Sameer Arora of Helios Capital as well. Sameer, good afternoon to you. If I remember your forecast on Twitter, you said 302, so congratulations, you came very, very close.
Well, in the end, it was quite far, but I came closer on my index target that we'll make 10% leading up to the outcome, and I think there's much more to go.
Are you disappointed, Sameer, that maybe you were expecting a bigger pop in this market given the decisive mandate that we've seen come in for the BJP and the NDA? We didn't quite get that, and in fact, in the last hour or so, we did also see substantial profit booking.
Well, the thing is that, you know, when I came on your channel about a month ago, I said 10% up to the election because nobody knew whether it will happen before the actual day, will it happen after exit polls, a thing like that. But broadly speaking, I think today, because the results are much better, although, you know, beyond a point, suppose you get 350 or 320, it does not matter to the market. The market wanted BJP, let's say, or BJP plus NDA to get to 272. After that, the marginal utility of a new guy is not there. You think the big picture only is that, in a sense, by everybody voting along the same lines, that is voting for reforms and governance, in a sense, it shows that people will no longer be able to rely on caste and communal angles to justify their existence. But other than that, in a big picture sense, whether you're 300 or 320 is not so literal a translation into the market.
Well, Sameer,
also, I heard about 5 minutes ago, 10 minutes ago, that maybe many individual retail brokers have increased their margins because of which maybe their sell-off happened. Well, if people still want to think about it, people think that the market knows more, they don't, market doesn't know as much. It is, we have to have a belief, markets don't discount these things so soon. This will go on for months and years. It's a new cycle, a new phase, a new round of optimism. And unless somebody breaks it, I think this will go on for a long, long time.
All right, Sameer, stay right there. We're going to have to take a quick commercial break. We're going to come back and talk about the markets and the economy in just a couple of minutes with Sameer Arora and our guests here in studio, Sanjay Nair and Nilesh.
आज ये पता चला गया कि हम केवल सरकार बनाने के ही मुद्रा में नहीं है, शुद्ध रूप में बीजेपी का नंबर इतना आ रहा है कि हम बिना किसी दबाव की सरकार बना सकते हैं। उसके बाद भी हम जो एनडीए के हमारे पार्टनर्स हैं उनको लेकर सरकार बनाएंगे और आगे की चीजें जैसे जैसे समय आएगा तय होंगी और वैसे वैसे आपको उत्तर भी मिलेगा।